Today, we're taking a look at the top 5 most iconic boots ever made. You know, those legendary boot silos that have somehow made their mark on football boot history, either by being worn by legends of the game, being around for a really, really long time, just in general being very good, or maybe have made some very important goals over the course of time. Of course, this is a top 5 list. I could have made a, say, top 20 list with all the separate models from each silo, but for simplicity, it's gonna be just about the silos and the top 5. Now, of course, also keep in mind that this is my personal top 5 list, which means that you might disagree. And if you do, hit me up with your personal top 5 most iconic boot list right down in the comment section below after the video. But now, let's get right into it. Number 5 is the Nike Tempo line, which originates all the way back to 1994 as the first, should we say, real football boot from Nike. Because Nike had made a few football boots before they made the Tempo, but A, they kinda sucked a little bit, and also B, they didn't really get a big push from Nike because they didn't really take football boots that seriously back then. So the Tempo kinda marked the real birth of Nike football. And after the introduction of the Tempo Legend line, we got 7 generations of very good, well-performing, comfortable, iconic boots. And on top of that, they were even worn by some of the legends of the game, pun intended, by the way. Just naming a few, I could say Pele, I could say Totti, I could say Ronaldinho, and the list kinda goes on. So for me, this is a no-brainer as an iconic boot in number 5. In 4th, we're gonna go a bit further back than 1994. In fact, we're gonna go super, super OG, because we're talking about the Puma King line. And let's be honest, this is not on the top 5 iconic list because of the modern King interpretations. They're not bad football boots, but the real OG King, the most iconic King, is the top DI and, of course, its older brothers. Because it's a comfortable, stylish boot that actually goes all the way back to 1968, where it was worn by a guy called Eusebio. He's one of the best Portuguese players ever, by the way, if you don't know him. And also, it was worn by, let's see, Maradona and Pele. So I think it's fair to say that the King has had a, you know, it kind of lives up to its name, depending on the players who's worn it. And this is just one of those iconic boots that really helped Puma establish its position amongst the very top brands out there. Now, number 3 here might be a wee bit controversial, and if you are over the age of 30, you might disagree with me, and disagree with me pretty hard, but there is a reason behind the madness. So I'm just gonna put it out there. My number 3 is the Adidas Copa Mundial. What, Jay? Are you insane? You call yourself a boot nerd? The Copa's number 3. What are you doing? Calm down, sit down. Calm your nerves. As I said, there is a reason behind the madness, because I grew up in the 90s. And remember, this is my personal top 5 most iconic boot list. So while I do recognize that the Copa is more or less one of the most recognizable football boots ever made, it's also a very, very good football boot. It's comfortable, it looks pretty good, it was worn by Zidane, even by Maradona, a lot of other legends of the game, and of course, more or less every football player over the age of 30. And even today, it's more or less the same as it was when it was first created back in 1979. So Adidas were onto something, and this is widely recognized as one of the best football boots that has ever been made. So it's number 3, Jay. What on earth are you doing? Listen, as I said, there is a reason behind the madness, because, as I mentioned, I grew up in the 90s, and that period and going forward, those 27 years, just made such a big change in the way we perceive football boots. Because the level of innovation was just unprecedented to what happened before the 90s began. I mean, we got synthetic boots, we got boots that had swerve elements, we got lightweight boots under, you know, 200 grams, even 100 grams. We got boots that changes colors, we got knitted football boots. You know, I could go on and on and on. And not just the level of innovation, but also looking at, you know, the exposure that football boots have gotten. They've become icons in themselves. And this is also the era where the best football boot players aren't just that. They're worldwide superstars, they're rock stars, some are movie stars, some are even sex icons. I mean, I wouldn't know. It's just changed so much, and you wouldn't see that back in the days of Copa Mundials. The marketing game is just different. So the modern era has just made football boots more iconic. Now that's a bold statement, And in my opinion, there are two silos that are more iconic than the Copa Mundial. In third place, Land Rover. In second place, we have one of the boot silos that beat the Copa Mundial for iconic status. But sadly, it's with us no more. I got this, guys, because we have the Adidas Predator silo. It was introduced in 1994, where it really blew everyone's minds by introducing the rubber fins that gave you more swerve and power. And as the commercial said back then, it was 100% legal and 0% fair, and you can kinda understand why. And over the years, all the Predator models, apart from probably the Predator X, which kinda sucked, have been really, really good football boots. But to me, one of the reasons that it was really iconic was, of course, the fact that most of the models had this red fold-over tongue. It was instantly recognizable. And then, of course, there's also the fact that it was worn by big legends of the modern game. Zidane, Beckham, Raul, Xavi, Gerard, the list kind of goes on. And for me, this is one of the best, most iconic boots of the modern era. Predator, I miss you. But before we move on to number one, I want to show some love to two of the boots that didn't quite make the list, which is a shame because they're good boots. The first is the Mizuno Morelia line, which originates all the way back to 1985. And it really always was a guarantee that you got brilliant comfort and elegant sensation on the ball and an extremely high build quality. And then, of course, there is the F50 line that, especially after the introduction of the F50 Adi Zero, really changed the way we look at lightweight speed boots. So a really, really iconic line for me as well. But enough of the honorable mention stuff. Let's move on to the big stuff, number one. Because in my humble opinion, the very most iconic football boot silo ever is the Nike Mercurial. Surprise, surprise, surprise. You probably saw that one coming. But this was actually made for Ronaldo back in 1998 for the World Cup. And since then, it's continued to really smash expectations and deliver the standards for innovation. Apart, of course, from the kind of sucky period it had from the Vapor 5 up until the Vapor 7. But not only has it been the front runner of innovation since its introduction, it's actually also been one of the most generally and widely sold football boots since it was introduced in 1998. And of course, it was only made more popular by the fact that it was worn by, as I said, R9, CR7, Zlatan Ibrahimovic, Thierry Henry, and of course, Lord Bentner himself. So if we're talking the impact that a football boot has made on the entire world of football boots, in my opinion, it doesn't get much more iconic than the Mercurial. I'm just saying. So, there you have it, guys. My personal top 5 most iconic boots ever made. But keep in mind that this is my personal list, and there might be a lot of people out there who disagree with me. If you're one of them, you should let me know what your personal top 5 most iconic boots list looks like in the comment section below. As you know, I love a good football boot discussion, so if you leave me a comment, I promise I'm gonna get an answer out to you. Also, don't forget to subscribe by clicking the green bubble somewhere over my head. Leave me a like if you had a good time and spread the word by sharing the video with your friends. And with that said, I'm signing off. Cheerio.